What's up, softball players? I'm Coach Dan Blewett. In today's video, we're going to talk about fast pitch throwing speeds by age. So this is not pitching speeds. This is overhand throwing speed. So if you want to learn how fast should I be throwing if I'm 12, I'm 14, I'm 16, 17, whatever, we're going to cover that in this video. We'll also talk about the factors that influence overhand throwing velocity, which is really important. Obviously, the more speed you have on your throw, the more you're going to be able to make plays at short. You're going to be able to get college recruiters interested in you. It's a really important factor that's a baseline fundamental for success in softball. All right, so if you're new here, I'm Coach Dan Blewett. In the description below, you'll find my online softball throwing courses, also free resources with drills, all that good stuff, a free webinar if you're looking to improve your throwing velocity or your daughter's throwing speed. So first thing, let's jump into it. Factors influencing velocity: physical maturity, size, limb length, weight, strength, throwing mechanics, athleticism, muscle fiber type. A lot of these things are things you can't control. Obviously, mechanics you can control, you can improve on. I have tons of videos on my YouTube channel here, so definitely check them out. I'll link to some in the description below that you should definitely check out. But physical maturity is one of the biggest ones. So if your daughter looks like she's 15, but she's actually 12, she's ahead of the game. That's probably one of the reasons she throws harder than other players. So understand that there's a laundry list of reasons that players will throw harder than each other that are not just mechanics. So understand that first. The other thing is how often a player throws, their mental intensity. So are they focused on working on their mechanics? Are they intense when they're trying to uncork one across the diamond? What's their arm care or arm strengthening program look like? Are they in the weight room a lot? And is their overall conditioning good? So beyond skill work, beyond their footwork, beyond their throwing mechanics, all the overall conditioning is important, and you also have to throw a lot if you want to be a better thrower. That's not to say you always have to throw more and more and more, because you definitely don't, but I know some players only throw like once a week all winter or twice a week all winter, and you can't really expect to be a better thrower from doing that. So consistently doing it, just like if you want to be a better sprinter, you have to actually go out and sprint. Throwing is a muscle that you have to, I mean, obviously throwing is not a muscle, but you have to do it if you want to get better at it. And obviously for me as a former pro baseball pitcher, throwing was my favorite thing in the world. So I was out throwing all the time, and that was how my mechanics got really good and how I got overall in great shape to throw a baseball. So understand, first thing, let's start to jump into some of the velocity stuff. You will not gain velocity in a linear fashion throughout your career. That's not real life. What will happen is that your velocity will go kind of up and down. You might gain no miles per hour from 12 to 13. Then you might gain 7 miles per hour from 13 to 14. Then you might gain 1 mile per hour from 14 to 15. Then you might gain six in the middle of your 15-year-old year. It's not a linear progression. It's a pretty bumpy line to the top. Obviously, one day you hope to throw in the 60s, and we'll talk about this as we get into this, but you know, it's not going to be a linear progression. So you have to really be diligent, and you have to really stick to it, and you have to trust your training and understand that even if you're not making gains on, you know, maybe you haven't made any gains this summer, maybe you're still throwing, you know, 54 just like you were 4 or 5 months ago, you have to stick with it and keep doing the right things, train hard, work on your mechanics, and trust that you'll break through eventually. I've seen this over and over, softball and baseball. It's just not a smooth, straight line to the top. There's setbacks. There's plateaus. Sometimes your body's just not ready to put out more power yet. Sometimes you have to wait for puberty, the next sort of growth spurt, all that stuff. But velocity gains are not a linear path to the top. The other big thing that I really want to make sure you understand is that developmental age is one of the biggest factors, is especially for you parents, in how hard players throw. On any given team at the youth level, you're going to have a huge spectrum of how developed any given player is relative to another. So you'll have 13-year-olds who are 76 pounds. You'll have 13-year-olds who are 176 pounds. You'll have 13-year-olds who are 4'9". You'll have 13-year-olds who are 5'9". And so, of course, the 5'9", 140-pound kid who's more like a 17-year-old than a 13-year-old is going to throw harder than the 13-year-old who's more like a 9-year-old. You see this all the time, and you can't outrun your developmental age. So your biological age, just because you're 16, you could look like you're 18 or you could look like you're 14. We all know this. So understand that this is a really big factor in how hard players throw. And a lot of parents, they start to panic when they realize that their daughter throws slower than everyone else on the team. But it's also because she just is physically way smaller and weaker because she just hasn't grown yet. So understand that you can't rush the process, and there's no hacks to get your body to suddenly add 10 miles per hour when you're only 86 pounds. It just doesn't work that way. So you have to wait to your growth spurts. You can still train hard and work on your mechanics and your footwork and all that good stuff. But ultimately, you can't outrun your developmental age. And developmental age is a big factor in why players throw harder than another, all other things constant. So in this video, we'll talk about velocity by age, and I'll go sort of like the low end, the average, and the high end, and the outliers for any given age bracket. So with that, we're just kind of going off the bell curve, right? Most players will be in the middle, which is sort of like average. I'm saying that's like 50 to 60% of players. And then the bottom 20%, the top 20%, and then the outliers are like the top 2% or so. So like one out of every 50 players might throw that hard. So for 10 and under, let's just start there. It really does not matter. Most 10-year-olds are going to be really small. They're going to be just focusing on loving the game, learning the fundamentals, getting their footwork down, learning good throwing technique, and also understand that for softball, especially, hand size is a huge factor. I'll link below to a video I did about hand size. But look, for a 9-year-old girl who's got really small hands, it's the equivalent of me throwing a volleyball. It's really, really hard, and it negatively impacts your mechanics. This is why I suggest all players learn on a baseball when they're young. Don't shy away from teaching your daughter to throw a baseball, to throw it with a tennis ball. It's really developmentally valuable to help them do that. Next, let's jump into ages 11 and 12. So on the low end, this is going to be players who essentially still throw in the high 30s. Average is going to be somewhere in the mid 40s. And high end is going to be in the high 40s, maybe creeping into the 50s. Players at ages 11, 12, who are usually still pretty small, if they're getting into the 50s, that's pretty impressive. So outliers are going to be, you know, in the mid 50s or above. And really the only players who are going to be able to produce that much force are going to be the kids who are physically bigger. They're going to be, they look like 14, 15 year olds, even though they're 12. They're going to have bigger hand sizes. They're going to have more muscle mass. They're going to be more powerful and explosive. And they're also going to be bigger, longer limbs. Like if your arms are long, like I'm 6 foot and I have a 6'2" or 6'3" wingspan, that helps me throw harder. That helps me throw harder for my frame. And so if you're a girl who's 5'8", when everyone else is 5 foot, you're going to have longer limbs and a longer whip essentially to throw that ball. So that's all important. So just understand that, again, most of the outliers are going to be physically more developed than everyone else in their grade. It's not like if you're a 85-pound 11-year-old that because your mechanics are so good, you're going to be able to throw a ball 55. That's just not going to, you're not going to have enough force in your body to probably do that. So that's a good overview of ages 11 and 12. Now at 13 and 14, this is where players really start to hit a more of a growth spurt. So you'll start to see players shoot up a lot more here because girls have that growth spurt earlier than boys do. And this is where if you're left at the low 40s, you're really going to start to struggle, especially as players get faster. And then the average here is going to be in the mid 40s into the 50s. And then you want to start to get into the 50s at this age, especially by 14. And then outliers here, again, like the really athletic, like more physically developed girls are going to start to get into the middle to upper 50s. And that's when they have to have pretty good mechanics to do that. And they're going to also have to be in the weight room and be pretty strong and explosive to do that. But it's definitely possible to start creeping into the mid to upper 50s by 14. And then at age 15, this is where players, they've hit their growth spurt. They start to sprout up. They're definitely capable if they have good mechanics and they're in the weight room and they've got a strong rotator cuff, they're doing their arm care to get into the mid 50s and start to see, you'll start to see some players who can throw 60 at this point. So with my academy, we had our own softball teams for a couple years. And when they were 16U, almost our entire team threw at least 55. And we had a number of girls throwing into the 60s at a 16U age team. So it's all possible just from good training and from good mechanics and consistency in the weight room. But at age 16, this is obviously a huge recruiting year for players. This is definitely where you hope to be in the mid 50s, upper 60s. But understand that if you're in the mid 50s, you're going to have enough velocity to play in college at that point. If you're in the low 50s, it's going to be really hard to play in college. I've been to a bunch of D1 games and I see a huge range of velocities. And you see a lot of college players, even D1 players, with poor throwing mechanics. Just because the field's so small, it allows some players to sneak through. But if you can get to that sort of magical 60 mile per hour mark, and it's not magical, every girl can get there with good mechanics and dedication to their training. But 60 is where you can throw a girl out from the hole at shortstop, and you can throw a girl out at the plate from medium outfield pretty easy. And it's where it really starts to change the game. So 60 miles per hour is a really good goal. I really do think it's attainable by almost all players who are dedicated to their training and have some athleticism. But at the least, you hope to get to around mid-50s by age 16. And the average is still in the low 50s. I mean, I took my radar gun to a really big high school, and it's like eighth grade, ninth grade tryout. And the average was like 46 to 52. And there were some girls who were in the 60s. But the average, the overwhelming majority of players were in still the high 40s, and that was creeping into high school age. So, you know, if you're in the upper 50s, then you're in good shape here at age 16. And at ages 17 to 18, you know, you're about to ship off to college. You'll start to see some of the more powerful, like the really premium athletes, start to get above 60 miles per hour, which again, there's a lot of zip on a softball throw that's in the 60s. And it's gotten to have good carry, and it's going to change. It's going to change the way the game is played, because as an outfielder, you're going to be able to hose girls at the plate. As a, you know, left side of the infielder, shortstop or third baseman, you're going to be able to make a lot more plays from deep in the hole. And your sidearm throws are going to be very effective if you have that much arm strength on tap. And as a catcher, you're going to be able to throw a lot of girls out if you've got 60 miles per hour or better on tap. So obviously that's a goal, right? You can't, like I said earlier, you can't rush the development of your throwing velocity as a fast pitch player. But when you're talking about working on your throwing mechanics and being the best fast pitch player that you can be, having a really good foundation of throwing velocity is important, because it allows you to play any position on the field. Your coach can trot you out to left. They can trot you out to right. They can put you at third base. And they know that you can make the play because you've got the arm strength to do it. And that's important. So one of the big things in college recruiting, to get a little off topic here, is just being somewhat flexible as a player. So coach says, man, I really love her bat, and she's got great speed. She's a good kid, and she's got great arm strength. They could teach you to play almost any position on the field. And that's really valuable. Coaches want to know that they can invest in a player knowing that, you know, I don't have to only put her at second base, or I don't have to only put her at first base. She could play lots of different positions as she learns and as our needs as a team change. So that's really important. That's what throwing velocity can do for you. So takeaways here, you know, you want to at least get to mid-50s. So wherever you are today doesn't mean you're stuck, right? You can always train harder, train smarter, find a good coach locally, you know, use one of my online courses, whatever it is, use my free videos. Whatever it is, you can always do better. So even if you're a late bloomer, I personally was a very late bloomer, you can always make a shift. So if you're in the low end of your velocity today, or your daughter is in the low end of these velocity scales today, it doesn't mean she's stuck there. You know, you can make a big leap in a year. You can make a big leap in a couple of years. You have to stick with it. And when you hit that growth spurt and you're training hard and things click for you mechanically, I've seen players gain 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 miles per hour in a year. It's not normal, but it happens, right? So if everything comes together, you can really see big gains, even though on average, you'll gain 3 or 4 miles per hour per year if you're training hard. But again, it's not going to be that linear, smooth progression. It's going to be kind of ups and downs and plateaus and spikes and all that stuff. But ultimately, you want to get to above 60. If you get to 60 and above, where you can consistently uncork 60 mile per hour throws, you're going to be in great shape to play at any level in college. 65 plus is a very rare level of arm strength. It's a very impressive level of arm strength. And that means, you know, if you want to play shortstop for Oklahoma, you'll have the arm strength to do it if you throw 65 or better, for sure. Like, that's really, really elite. And I've only seen one 70 mile per hour thrower in my career as a coach and a baseball and softball academy owner. She was an impressive athlete. It's very, very rare, and it's hard to do that. If you have an arm like that, kudos to you. That's kind of like the equivalent of being a baseball player who throws in the upper 90s. Me personally, I could throw a softball. I think the hardest I ever threw a softball was 84, and I could throw a baseball up to 94. So gives you a little bit of context. That's so for women who I don't know what the hardest baseball throw on record is, but probably in the mid 80s from a woman. So, you know, maybe a girl gets up to 75, which is also super impressive. But again, the thing to understand is that on the small softball field, you don't necessarily ever need to throw a ball 75. As an outfielder, the harder is better. As a catcher, harder is better. But for a lot of these short throws in the infield, if you can throw 60, you're going to be in great shape to make really impressive plays, even with the fastest runners. All right. So hopefully today's video was helpful. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Check out the description links where you'll find my online throwing courses, which can help you improve your mechanics step by step, no matter what your experience level is. And I'll link to other helpful videos to help you improve your mechanics here on YouTube. Thanks again for watching. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.